Hello everyone, I'm going to talk about our recent work on tackling the problem of erasure errors with the help of multi-level systems. This work has been carried out at Yale University. Erasure errors takes various forms such as leakage errors, qubit losses, or photon losses. Specifically for photon losses, they lead to an exponential penalty in terms of resources and time. Suppose we have an optical fiber of length L. The probability of receiving the photon through the other end of the fiber decreases exponentially with the length of the fiber. In this paper, we propose to use quantum polynomial codes for correcting erasure errors. The simplest example is a 3-qutrit code which can correct one erasure error. The implementation we have for this code is to store a bosonic excitation into multiple modes so that loss of a photon corresponds to a vacuum state leading to an erasure error. This code can be generalized to quantum polynomial codes which encodes 2k plus 1 qubits, each with a dimension d, into a single logical qubit so that it can correct up to k erasure errors. It can correct up to a fraction of k over 2k plus 1, which is close to 50% for a large k. So how do we perform error correction for loss and operation errors on qubits? Here, we have generalized teleportation-based error correction for multi-level systems using a sum gate which acts on I and j as I plus j mod d. The incoming state comes with loss and operation errors and the logical qubit leaves the circuit with errors corrected. Now we have an efficient method to perform error correction for qubits. How do we transmit quantum states across long distances? One solution for this is to build repeater station and have a teleportation-based error correction procedure to correct for loss and operation errors for quantum polynomial codes at these stations. Here, we show the key generation rates that's attainable with small quantum polynomial codes, namely the 7-qubit, the 5-qubit, and the 3-qubit codes with 1 km repeater spacing in the absence of operation errors. We see that it's possible to communicate until 10,000 km with the 7-qubit code. Here, we show the performance of key generation rates in the presence of small operation errors. We see that as operation errors go over 10⁻⁴, key generation rates reduce rapidly. For the sake of comparison between different codes for quantum repeater applications, we have a cost coefficient which is given by the number of qubits required per kilometer to generate one secure bit in 1 second. We can compare the qubit-based and qubit-based schemes by assuming that each qubit of d levels can be mapped into log d to the base 2 qubits. Here, we identify the parameter regimes where quantum polynomial codes perform better than qubit-based quantum parity codes. Firstly, in our error model, we have assumed operation errors increase as a function of dimension of the qubit d. More precisely, we assume gate error scales as d power 4, depolarization error scales as d square, and dephasing error scales as d. We plot the ratio of the cost coefficient of the quantum parity codes and quantum polynomial codes in the counterplot. The region below, the counterline 1, shows the region where polynomial codes perform better than quantum parity codes. Conclusion: we use quantum polynomial codes which can correct up to 50% erasure rates for quantum repeater applications. We identify the parameter regime where they perform better than qubit-based quantum parity codes. In addition, one can extend the coding schemes to continuous variables. Thank you very much.